John, unlucky today. Frankston just took the game over in the second half.
We came out a little flat, you know, not like we expected to come out. They brought a lot of energy, and, you know, it's an area where we're usually good in, which we didn't capitalize on, so we just want to improve on it for next week against Geelong.
Your own game, how did you see it?
I felt pretty confident. I was a little nervous, a little anxious, being my first game in over a year. And there's some things I feel like I could have done better to help my team win that I definitely want to improve on, like very soon, like next game soon.
You mentioned Geelong there next week. What's it going to be like going back to your old stadium?
I'm not really sure. I'm sure there'll be some type of emotions and feelings there, you know. Probably really anxious again. But I think it'll be a fun and exciting game, you know, see some familiar faces and compete against a good team. I'm really looking forward to it.
John, just tell us a little bit about your story over the last 18 months. Last time we saw you here, you were at Geelong, as I mentioned. Just tell us what's happened since then and now.
Yeah, well, I was at Geelong in the off-season. My fiance, you know, got pregnant, so we have a son now who's a nine-month-old. His name is Christopher. So, you know, from playing basketball, you know, I'm now soon to be married and I have a son. So it was definitely an adjustment sitting out a year. You know, I was trying to put my family first. So I feel I made the right decision. I feel like it helped me grow as a person. It's really showed me a lot about life. So it's been definitely a long, long journey, and I'm just happy to be back on the right foot.
Well, mate, we're happy to have you back in SEABL. Unlucky today, but we're excited that you're back in the league. Good luck next week, and thanks for your time.
All right, thank you, sir.